Hello everyone, we start from our previous lecture. In our previous lecture, we have completed our 5 examples on groups. Now this is our 6th example, and from that slide we will continue. So example number 6 is, let G equal to A such that A is a non-singular matrix of order n over R. Show that G is a group with respect to usual multiplication of matrices. So solution, first we see that this G is closed, okay, means any two elements from that G, then the multiplication of that two elements is also belongs to G. So we have to take for that two elements, let A comma B belongs to G. So as the definition of the group, that A is non-singular matrix of order n. So here we have to take A and B, so both are, that A and B are non-singular matrices of order n. What is meant by non-singular? That is, their determinant is non-zero. That is, determinant of A is non-zero and determinant of B is non-zero. As a determinant of both A and B is non-singular, therefore their product is equal to determinant of AB is equal to determinant of A into determinant of B is also non-zero, and therefore AB belongs to G. Okay, because it is, that product is also non-singular, and thus the multiplication of matrices is a binary operation that is closed on G. Also we know that the matrix multiplication is associative, that is AB into C equal to A into BC, for every ABC belongs to G. So there is nothing to prove the second property. Now in third property, that is existence of identity, for any A belongs to G, A into IN means identity matrix on n elements, equal to A, equal to IN into A, where IN is the identity matrix of order n in G, and therefore IN is the identity element of G. And now fourth property, that is inverse, for that let A belongs to G. But what is A? A is your non-singular matrix, therefore its determinant is not equal to 0. Now take any element that we have to define here, B, equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A belongs to G, then also B belongs to G. Why? Because it contains A, also determinant of A. Now A into B equal to A into that value of B, 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. That is, now use the associativity property. Put 1 upon determinant of A on outside and A takes inside. So 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. But what is A into adjoint of A? It is determinant of A into IN. Okay. So it is 1 upon determinant of A into IN. From where this will come? This is the result that you have to be already studied in FIBSC standard, FIBSC matrix algebra paper, that A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. So this is the result from FIBSC. Now cancelling this determinant of A on numerator and denominator, we get to value is equal to IN. Means AB equal to IN, that is identity element, and therefore B is the inverse of A. And what is the value of inverse? That is 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. So similarly we have to prove that BA equal to also IN, and hence A inverse equal to B equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. And thus every element of G has inverse in G, and all the properties are satisfied, and therefore G dot is a group. Okay. Now again one more very important example, example number 7. Let Q plus, means positive element, denote the set of all positive rationals. For A, B belongs to Q plus, define A star B equal to AB by 2. Show that Q plus comma star is a group. Clearly, closure property is already there, that clearly A comma B belongs to Q plus, then implies A star B equal to AB by 2, already defined here. It also belongs to Q plus. Now we check the associativity property. For that we take here three elements. Let A comma B comma C belongs to Q plus. Now consider the LHS, that A star B star C equal to AB by 2 star C. Now consider this AB by 2 is a single element, and this is that is first element, and C is your second element. And again applying this property that A star B equal to AB by 2. Okay. So this is A, so A star B means AB by 2 star C, star C, so this is your B actually, so AB by 2 into C upon 2, okay, this is your A and this is your B, so AB by 2, and after simplifying, fine, we get ABC by 4. Again on right hand side, A star B star C equal to A star. What is B star C? It is BC by 2. Again we take this as a single element, so and use again our given criteria that A star B equal to AB by 2. You get A BC by 2 upon 2, and again simplifying we get the value is equal to ABC by 4. So LHS equal to RHS, and therefore star is associative. Now third, for existence of identity, we have to define here an element. So for A belongs to Q plus, consider A star 2 equal to A2 by 2. This is again by this given property, where B equal to 2. So A star 2 equal to A2 by 2, and after cancelling 2 by 2, it is A. Similarly, 2 star A equal to 2A by A, and again A. So 2 is the identity element of Q plus. Okay. Now for existence of inverse, again we have define one more element. So let A belongs to Q plus, then 4 by A is also belongs to Q plus, and after multiplying these two elements, this 4 by A we have to be taken. Okay. So A into 4 by A, that is AB by 2 for properties. So B is your 4 by A. So this is A 4 by A by 2. After cancelling AA and 4 by 2 means 2 2's are 4, so it is 2. So this is the identity. Okay. Because the definition of inverse is A star B equal to E. So on the right hand side we want E. E means identity. Here identity is 2. And again 4 by A star A, if we multiply it, then it is 4A into A by 2, and again its value is 2, and therefore here A inverse is your 4 by A. Got it? So hence Q plus comma star is a group because all the four properties are satisfied here. So these are some examples on the group, and very important examples. Now there is a note. Now onwards, unless otherwise stated, by a group G we mean a group G star. Okay, means after then we called the group or notation for the group as a G star. By AB we mean A into B, and by an element E belongs to G we mean E is the identity element of G. Is always is identity element in a group G. So these are some notations. Now we start the properties of the groups, means theorem part. There are lots of theorems in this paper and also in this chapter. So we see one by one. If G is a group, then number one, that we have to be proved, prove that identity element of G is unique. Second is, every element of G has unique inverse in G. third is A inverse, inverse is equal to A for every A belongs to G. And fourth is reversal law for the inverse of a product, that AB inverse equal to B inverse A inverse for every A comma B belongs to G. Now we see the proof one by one. Number one, that we have to be proved that identity element of G is unique. So we suppose that for uniqueness, we take here two identity elements. Okay, so suppose let E and E dash be identity elements of G. Then what is our aim? That identity is unique. So but we have to prove that E equal to E dash. If we prove E equal to E dash, means that identity is one and only one, that is unique. So we try it. So let E and E dash be the identity elements of G. Therefore, by definition of identity, E into E dash equal to E. When E dash is an identity element of G. And also E into E dash equal to E, or E dash into E equal to E, when E is the identity element of G. Okay. So actually, here is some printing mistake. Just a minute. So here is not E, here is E dash. Okay. So please, when you write the notes, then put here E dash. Okay. And here take E dash into E. Okay. So that E into E dash is equal to E, and E dash into E equal to E dash. Okay. When E is identity element. Okay. Now we see that left hand side will equal that E into E dash or E dash E dash into E. So right hand side is also equal. Okay. And therefore E equal to E dash, and hence identity element of G is unique. Now second, let A belongs to G. What is second? That every element of G has unique inverse in G. Again, for the solution of uniqueness, we take two inverses that is similar to first. So let A belongs to G, and suppose that B and C are the inverses of A and G. So for our claim, we have to prove that B equal to C. If we prove that B equal to C, then inverse is also unique. For that, we see the solution. Now suppose that if B and C are the inverses of A and G, then by definition of inverse, if B is the inverse of A, then AB equal to E equal to BA. And if C is the inverse of A, then AC equal to E equal to also CA. This is by definition of inverse. Now B equal to EB. Okay, we have to prove that B equal to C. So we take on LHS B, but we can write B equal to EB. But E is CA. E is CA. So CA into B. Use associative law, that is C into AB. But what is AB? AB is E. So it is C into E. That is C. And therefore B equal to C. And hence A has unique inverse in G. Now third property, that A inverse inverse equal to A. It is very easy because by definition of inverse, it is clearly. So let A belongs to G. So by definition of inverse, A into A inverse equal to E equal to A inverse into A. And therefore by definition of inverse of an element, A is the inverse of A inverse. Sorry. And therefore A inverse inverse equal to A. Now number 4. That is reversal law for the inverse of a product. So consider we have taken this LHS that for any two elements AB belongs to G, A comma B belongs to G. Consider AB into B inverse E inverse equal to, simplify this by associativity, AB into B inverse, and take out A inverse outside. So this is by associativity. Now again by associativity, collect the terms of B, that is A into B, B inverse into A inverse. But B into B inverse is identity. So A into identity equal into A inverse.
But A into E is A. So A into A inverse, we get again it is E. So by definition of inverse, we see that if two elements are multiplied and their product is identity, then first element is inverse of other and other element is inverse of first. Similarly, we also found that B inverse into A inverse into AB here also equal to identity. So by 1 and 2, B inverse E inverse is the inverse of AB. This is by definition of inverse. And therefore, AB inverse equal to B inverse A inverse. In this part 4, we have to remember only this term, that is consider A into B equal to B inverse into A inverse. After then, the calculation is very simple. From this last fourth property, this is the general remark of reversal law of a product of elements. So for that, here you have given the remark: if a1 comma a2 dot dot an are the elements of a group G, then reversal law can be written as a1 a2 a3 dot 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 an inverse equal to an inverse n minus 1 inverse dot 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 a2 inverse a1 inverse, full stop. Okay, so this is a general remark. Now we see the another one theorem, and after then we will stop here. So another one theorem is cancellation laws. Let G be a group and A comma B comma C belongs to G, then there are two cancellation laws. First is left cancellation law and second is right cancellation law. So if AB equal to AC, then after cancellation A on both sides, we get B equal to C. And for right cancellation law, if BA equal to CA, then after cancellation A on both sides, we get B equal to C. So we see the solution one by one. First, you have given that AB equal to AC. So AB equal to AC. Now pre-multiplying both sides by A inverse, we get pre-multiplying means, what is mean by pre? Agodar. Okay? Before. So multiplying A inverse before to this AB equal to AC. Okay? So A inverse into AB equal to A inverse into AC. Now by associative law, A inverse A into B equal to A inverse A into C. But by definition of inverse, A inverse A into A inverse into A is E. So EB equal to here again EC. Okay? But EB is B and EC is C. So we get B equal to C. So this is about the left cancellation law. Now for right cancellation law, you have given BA equal to CA. And therefore, we have taken here BA equal to CA. Now post multiplying both sides by A inverse. What is mean by post after multiplying? Nantar. Okay. We get BA into A inverse equal to CA into A inverse. Now again by associative law, we get B into AA inverse equal to C into AA inverse. But by definition of inverse, we get BE equal to CE. And therefore, what is the value of BE? It is B. What is the value of CE? It is C. And therefore, we get again B equal to C. So, this is about the left and right cancellations law. Now, we will stop here. And in our next lecture, we see our next theorem, that is theorem 1.6. And also see more theorems in this chapter. Till now, we stop here. Thank you.